Well, hell, let's go. Let's get it on. Skyroom, please, a loud welcome for G.R.L.
Hello.
We'll start with a song and then questions.
Everybody's got their Chipotle.
Yeah, we just ate some.
Yeah.
Really good.
We're waiting to eat our Chipotle.
What are we waiting for? Oh, they'll chew with their mouth open. It's fine. You can continue. At least you'll cover up the smacking noises from the audience.
All right, here we go. Well, this is our collaboration with Pitbull, Wild Wild Love.
We'll get to that in a second. Let me start somewhere else. How did this happen? How did you all come together? Because you all have performance backgrounds, correct?
Yes.
Please introduce yourself.
Well, I'm Simone.
I'm Emmeline.
I'm Lauren.
I'm Natasha.
What's up? I'm Paula. And we are...
G.R.L.
Sorry,
you were doing it. You're a little intense.
You got really
intense. I had coffee.
It was coffee?
It's a crazy coffee.
It's extremely affected by caffeine. Like, it is out of this world.
And you kind of look like you're going to rob a bank.
You're
hip hop dancing.
I call these
like
invisible glasses.
Oh, okay. So
you
shield you? Somebody actually who performed here one time said that he always wears his sunglasses because then people can't see into his soul.
Oh, that's why.
I'm a window, too.
Yeah, I was a little weirded out by that.
I like to close my eyes when I sing. So
it's
kind of weird when you're like,
sorry. One more
time. I'm for the glasses, so I don't look good.
So, performance backgrounds.
Okay, so I was kind of gigging around West Hollywood at the gay club, performing, and I had heard about it through word of mouth that Robin Anton was looking to start a new girl group.
Mm-hmm.
And so, I guess she'd see, I performed on X Factor the first season that I came to America, and she'd see me dancing and singing on TV, and, you know, I got a call one day, and I came and I met the girls. We all kind of sat around in Lauren's studio apartment around the guitar, and we kind of
kumbaya.
Yes, we like to call it. We do the kumbaya. The vibes were just good. Everybody's personalities just clicked together. We just realized that we wanted to do it together. So, that was me in a nutshell.
Your story?
Me? My story? Well, I'm from Vancouver, Canada. I actually posted covers online. I did a couple of songs, and Lauren actually found me, and Robin found me online for the group, and then that's when I moved out to L.A., and I joined the group.
Lauren?
I was good friends with Robin Anton because I used to be in a girl group called Tidy, so I was with her, and she wanted to start a new project, and I was the first member to be on board. We kind of just went from there.
You also
kind of boring story.
Kind of had. I think you kind of had a big collaboration too, didn't you?
I did.
Yeah.
A little collaboration.
You guys remember Party Rock Anthem?
Yeah.
Boom. on the hook right there. That's Lauren. Natasha.
Well, my story is even more boring. Oh, this is interesting. I was doing my own.
Stop it, you silly girl.
I was doing my own solo artist thing, writing songs and performing around town and dancing as well. And Lauren and I were friends, but she didn't. I guess you heard through our mutual friends that I sang and danced. Is that what it was? And you looked me up.
Well, I had your friend tell me about a song that she had this song on iTunes, and I downloaded it.
What?
And I was like, oh, that's really good.
I'll give her $1.
And then I did a little online research. And I sent some of her videos over to Robin, and she checked her out.
Yeah.
And so Robin's obsessed with, like, dancing. She always trying to get up and dance.
Wasn't there... one of you is dancing like for. Yeah, right?
That's boring. That's not boring.
Okay, yeah, let's try tapping here. Boring. Go.
Okay, cool. I worked with Robin's brother, Stephen Anton, on. I did do that show, but Burlesque. He's seen Burlesque with Christina Aguilera and Sharon. So, yeah, I knew Stephen Anton, who obviously knows Robin Anton. And. Yeah, they wanted, or Robin started doing a group, and he mentioned me, and I met with Robin, and we're best friends now, and I'm in the room. I was a dancer, and now I'm a singer.
Who's the, who's like the slobby one? Because there's always a slobby one.
Why do you want to have a slobby one?
I think that you're the sloppy one.
Why?
I don't know.
What is that?
Really?
I had a feeling you're gonna think I was sloppy because you know you're sloppy, so you think I'm sloppy because we're like
best
same
friends.
Brain.
Then she's very neat. She actually will come over to my house and like I just hate making my bed because I'm gonna get back into it. She always makes my bed and. I'll do my
thing. You have to make your bed. You know, it just makes like the day start. Like,
if
your bed's done, you're out of the bed. You know, now you start your day. If the bed's unmessy, you're not starting
your
day.
Mom. Are you like the mom of the group?
We're all kind of mommy, but I have mommy moments.
Are you gonna sing it next time she does it? It's the mommy moment.
It's the mommy moment.
Speaking of your little jingle here, what were you singing when you were sound checking your little players?
Come on!
A year ago, we did a mall tour where we went to a bunch of Claire's. Claire sponsored our tour. They like painted our bus with our faces on it, and
we had a jingle.
Nobody came to see us because nobody knew who we were. So we were just like sitting at these booths, like begging people to sign autographs. Hi, we're GRL. Like, come get an autograph. And we had a lot of time to kill, so we made up a jingle.
Go.
Ready? Five, six, seven.
It's Claire's for planning the accessories. It's Claire's for all the young girls out there. How can you not use that gold?
I think we can only go to another song after that.
Okay, let's redeem ourselves.
This is a real song. This one is called Show Me What You Got. And basically letting all the boys out there know that if they want to get down with the girls, they better show us some respect.
Yeah. Stop. We're talking to you.
I need this.
Show me what you mean.
could be a billionaire, but that will get you this. Ha.
Hey, boy, tell me.
You'll be there when they need you.
Hey, boy, tell me.
Why should I just believe
you? Get it wrong, it's you. But I'm just not that girl. So don't just tell me.
Please show me what you mean.
If you wanna be with me, show me what you got.
It's hard to do a room like this sometimes when you're right in front of people 6 feet away, so I congratulate you. I'm impressed, very, very impressed. Anybody got any questions for G.R.L.? Anybody? You're on the spot, right there, front row.
If you guys could spend your money at, like, one store, just, like, have a giant shopping spree, what store would you pick?
That's great.
Nasty Gal.
Ooh, that's a good one.
We don't have Nasty. We have Nasty Gal.
Shoe. I'll say Top Shop.
Ooh. Top Shop. Top, your pimp.
What if I pick, like, Sears?
You definitely look like a washer, dryer, chainsaw kind of girl.
Yeah, I would Chipo.
Sephora. I love makeup.
You're gonna say Home Depot.
I'm so down for Home Depot.
I was at Home Depot today.
I
had to get some shelves. Pretty exciting trip. You know, maybe a little Bed Bath and Beyond later if I have time. Anybody get it? Anybody get the reference? Womp womp womp. Is it mandatory? Is the dress code mandatory to wear huge heels?
Wow. It makes you feel empowered.
I gotta try that.
You want to try
them on? I'm like a 9.5. Do you think they would fit? Can you send me a pair? I can't wait for that. All over Twitter. That's gonna be fantastic. The record. Let's talk about the record and who you're working with, who you're writing with.
Well, we just put out our EP.
Yes.
It's our self-titled EP. It just came out July 29th. So.
Oh, the dude with the GRL tie definitely bought it. Do you see that? Stand up, bro. Stand up. Hold
it.
Necktie.
That
is so cool.
Awesome.
We need a picture of that.
Thank you.
Whoa.
Whoa.
Dude, that's what you get when you spend time at Home Depot. You make it.
Right?
EP's out. Who'd you write with? Who'd you work with?
We work with Dr. Luke.
Yep.
Max Martin, Esther Dean, Circuit,
Jay Cash,
a lot of cool names. It's very eclectic. It's got like kind of a song for everybody. We've got kind of. It's also very girl charged. Like a lot of anthems that are, you know, like we have this one song, "Girls Are Always Right." I don't know if you agree.
I know that. I know that.
Do you know that? Do you live that?
I don't agree with that, but that doesn't mean I stand up for it. I mean, I just agree, like, to disagree. And I'm like, yeah, I'm going to go to Home Depot now.
Make it easy.
Okay.
We got a song called Show Me What You Got, which we just played, basically letting all the boys know what's up. and Ugly Heart, our single, we are working that right now. It's basically about inner beauty and about seeking and embodying inner beauty because what's really important is what's on the inside, you know?
So, yeah, sorry, we're totally what it's supposed to do.
Yeah, you guys are sitting here.
Very eclectic. We call Ugly Heart our Hawaiian hoedown. It's a ukulele and it's kind of like got this like country feel to it.
Yes.
I came up with that. I did.
Well done. How did the Pitbull record happen? Is that a Dr. Luke thing? Was that the connection there?
Yeah, Pitbull.
Yeah.
I mean, Dr. Luke kind of has some good connections.
Yes.
If you don't know who Dr. Luke is, he's a producer. He produces for Britney Spears, Katy Perry, Kesha, yeah. Miley,
Ariana Grande.
You know, just to name a few.
Just a few.
Few of those. So he has some hookups. And
I'm a huge, huge fan of the single. I would love to hear it.
Okay.
You get to hear it.
Here it is.
Thank you. one time, Skyroom for GRL. I think it's time to do some photos. What do you say, guys? Is that cool? Get your Facebook profile photo.
Yes.
I do.